guests tonight are co-host Merle Kilgore, superstar Hank Williams Jr., along with the Bama Band, and RCA recording artist Lori Morgan, and Big Bill Lister. And now, live from Opryland, USA, here's the host of Nashville Now, Ralph Emery.
Thank you very much, and good evening, everybody. We welcome you to our show. And now I would like to bring out a dear friend of mine and an old friend of mine. Sometimes I call him the Boogie King because he made a record of that title once. And he is one of the few people that I know of who has worked both with Hank Williams Sr. and Hank Williams Jr. Would you please welcome Merle Kilgore?
These are my people, I tell you. Hey, Ralph. So good to be back with you. TNN, Nashville Now. This is heaven.
How are you?
Hey, I'm doing great.
The Boogie King.
Yes, and now Senator of the state of Tennessee.
Excuse me, I didn't...
Honorary.
Honorary.
Yes.
You mean that the legislature has made you a senator?
Yes. You know, Elvis Presley had Colonel Tom Parker. And when I took over management, he had to have something. So Hank said, why don't you be a senator? So we called some people, and the legislature was so kind enough to make me...
Senator? I have to call you Senator Kilgore?
Henry County.
I don't know whether I can get used to that or not.
All my friends call me Senator.
I'll work on that.
Okay, good.
Now, are you officially manager of Hank Williams Jr.?
Yes, I am.
In the Hank Jr. hierarchy?
Yes.
Okay. All right. And who have you brought tonight?
I have brought some exciting people. First of all, I brought a group that is just fantastic. We had them here last year.
Now, I don't want them to play just yet.
Not yet.
Okay.
Then I brought a guy from Texas who is an absolute legend in Texas, who has made a happening that the absolute world from Australia, England, can thank this man before. Because he found an acetate, a recording in his attic of Hank Williams Sr. singing a song called There's a Tear in My Beer, and it's become an international hit, as well record as video by Hank Jr.
As I understand it, he found this old acetate.
That's right.
Which was a demonstration record.
That's right.
And got in touch with you and Hank, and then Hank got the idea to record with his father, and then the video came along next and so forth.
Right.
And the man who actually found the record is here tonight.
Big Bill Lister.
Okay. Well, of course, Hank's here.
Yes, both Cephas.
And what is the crazy guy's name who fronts this band?
Animal.
Animal, that's it. How can I forget?
It's because he attacks pizza. It's unbelievable.
You know, I wish some night, I want you to come out here when we've got a chance to tell them some of the stories I know about you. See, usually
about me?
Yeah, when you come out here, we usually talk about Hank, right?
That's right.
But we go back a long way.
I know.
And I could tell them some terrific...
Please don't tell us.
No, these are interesting.
Oh, okay.
I can tell them about some of the predictions you made about my life that came true.
The yard.
When you used to be into that sort of thing?
Yeah.
You were reading tea leaves and all that? Candles? But anyway, Animal's here?
Yes.
Okay. If you look closely, you will notice one of our guests. He is your typical country singer, I guess. We call him Animal, and he is here with the Bama Band.
Friday night, fixed up pretty, and I just got my pay. We hop in the truck and head for the city a half an hour away. We hit every barroom door, dance on every hardwood floor, do it all more. When we're done, the best part of the night is yet to come. When we get back to the farm, that's when we're really going to town. When I've got you in my arms, and there's no one else around, there's so many sights to see. When we roll those covers down, when we get back to the farm, that's when we really go to town. Sure is good to go to the city and have a little fun, but it ain't long till we're good and ready to get back one-on-one. Neon lights are fine to see, but they don't shine like you and me when we turn the key, lock the door. I wonder what we ever leave here for when we get back to the farm. That's when we really go to town. When I've got you in my arms and there ain't no one else around. There's so many sights to see when we roll those covers down. When we get back to the farm, that's when we really go to town. When we get back to the farm, that's when we really go to town. When I've got you in my arms and there ain't no one else around, there's so many sights to see when we roll those covers down. When we get back to the farm, that's when we really go to town.
That's the Merle, if you will, I want you, Animal, I want all of you to just stand there for a second. Merle, would you introduce the band?
Yes, I'd love to introduce the Bama band. Wayne Turner during the vocals there when we get back to the farm.
Wayne Turner.
Wayne Turner. His close friends call him Animal. Now let's go to screen left, and hey, on the piano, the debonair Billy Earhart.
Okay.
He's got a Grammy, by the way.
Billy.
He used to be with the Amazing Rhythm Aces.
I see.
He has a Grammy. We're okay. So jealous of him. And on the bass, that slim guy from Louisville, Kentucky, Ray Berkman on the bass, ladies and gentlemen. On the tubs, and he boasts having the most drums on the road than any drummer in country music, from Memphis, Tennessee, Bill Marshall.
Okay.
Oh, that's right, he moved to Nashville. Hey, welcome to Nashville. And looky here on the steel guitar with that special shirt he bought today. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Cowboy Eddie Long. Got a lot of friends from Atlanta, Georgia. We have a new member in the Bama band. This guy's from Memphis. He's played with a lot of big, big artists. Now he's playing with the best. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome Mr. Dominic Conjardo? Oh, Dominic, that's a baritone sax. Has a big old bass sound.
All right. Boom.
And here's a guy that absolutely slays him, too. From Memphis, Tennessee, the tenor sax, Jerry McKinney.
Okay.
The Bama band.
Gentlemen, we thank you very much. I want to ask you a question, and we need to change bands so you guys can go ahead, okay? Oh, they have to play us into the break? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. All right, we'll do this, and I'll ask my question in a minute.
Oh, sure.
I will tell you, let me first of all tell you that Johnny Cash, we announced, would be here tonight. He is sick. Johnny Cash, I talked to Reba this afternoon,
yes.
His sister, and John wanted folks to know that he was sorry he could not be here. I know he got sick on the record session yesterday.
Yes.
And He has been advised by his doctor to take about 10 days off. But on tonight's show, Hank Williams Jr., the Bama Band, Miss Lori Morgan, and Big Bill Lister, and, of course, Senator Merle Kilgore. We'll be right back.
Pass the word for TNN.
Is this the new Hank Jr. we're about to see on television tonight?
No, just same old Hank.
Well, no, there's something new. He's got a new look. When he walked by you a moment ago, he said, "Here, Merle, hold this." And he threw you his hat. See, normally he sings on this show in a hat. Then I saw him in the paper the other day without
Ralph, we
without
must
that.
Move forward in this business.
Well, he looks good, I think.
I love it.
I assume, but this is his new look, right?
Kind of.
Well, I'm going to say it whether you say it or not. The new Hank Williams Jr., here he is.
The entertainer.
Radio station don't sign off with Dixie. Up there the way they did in Sweet Home, Alabama. People didn't offer me no Jim Beam whiskey the way they did in the Tennessee Mountain Range. They said, "Son, you're gonna play the Big Apple."
Take a look. Son, you're looking good.
Yeah?
I like your look.
Well, you know.
There's hope for Charlie Daniels.
Hell yeah. You know, when you've been in this business 32 years, like me, that's what it adds up to.
Is it 30?
Frightening, isn't it?
32 years?
Yes. Since they put me on the stage, that was 32 years ago. Of course, I was 1 year old when they put me on stage.
You know what? Hoot had a hand in this. There's some old men, gentlemen down in Dixon County who used to tape my all-night show when they thought it was significant. And I was just telling Merle, I've got a tape of the two of us.
Yeah.
January 1, 1968.
Yeah.
We're doing a tribute to your father. And the big thing that night was the fact that they had added strings to Hank Sr.'s records.
Remember it well. Yeah.
And of course they added you to his records.
Oh yeah.
And I guess they have released them every way possible.
They've added everything that can be added to Daddy's records, you know.
And what is the significance of this week's Billboard magazine?
Well, I just found out about it a few days ago. They
It's the Billboard Spotlight. It's
a spotlight.
It's a salute they have. Well, this is Hank's third spotlight in 32 years.
I didn't even know that till Merle told me.
His third
unbelievable.
Spotlight.
They did.
Right there, there's a special
15 or 20 pages on me in there, and it's for me to sit there and look at all that and read. Well, just like you were talking about, there's a picture of me and Merle there, and I'm 14 years old in that picture.
Happened 25 years ago, May 1st, 1964.
You've been with Merle for 25 years?
25 years.
How long were you with his daddy?
I was with his daddy when he was 48, and he left in 49.
Yeah.
Okay, let me show you the picture you're talking about. This, this will give you an idea. Was this when you first went with him?
Yes.
Yeah.
This was at the top was yesterday and at the bottom today.
Right. He would tear my guitars all to pieces.
I was showing him how Johnny Cash played a guitar and eat up the finish.
And I would tell Mother and then they would discuss it.
I know how you
know how that was discussed.
The big A. The big A.
Tooth and nail.
Now, I understand. I want to show them one more thing.
Yeah.
I understand this is rather significant.
Yes, it is.
So I'll show them and you tell them why. This is the back of the Billboard magazine. And the ad, I understand, was done by an amateur.
Yes, a young man who goes to a college in Los Angeles, works for Warner Brothers in the shipping department. And a memo was sent out by Vic Faraci, who is executive, one of the vice presidents of Warner Brothers, said, come up something with an ad for Hank Williams Jr. Anybody have any ideas? And this kid who's a big Hank Jr. fan, he said, Bo Cephas is this, Bo Cephas is that, and it did it like a dictionary.
Bo Cephas is now in the dictionary.
they took it like a dictionary.
Hank, let me ask you this. The other night, I saw on one of the cables, I was off all last week, Your Cheating Heart.
I saw the same one.
And then, of course, later they made a picture about your life.
Yeah.
I remember you didn't like the actor. Remember that story?
Oh, sure.
You learned to like him. But my question is, will there be a definitive life of Hank Williams movie made in the future?
Well, there should be. You know, I don't know that there will be, but there should be, because when I look at that now in 1989, with George Hamilton portraying Hank Williams and my 16-year-old voice
singing
being
song.
Pantomimed by him, it's not too great, you know. And I'm talking about from the technical end. If I was producing the music, and you know, you got a 16-year-old kid, his voice is you know.
Yeah, how about the storyline?
Well, the storyline will. I'll put it this way: I have never watched Your Cheating Heart in its entirety and probably never could get through it.
Why is that?
Because it's too close to home for me, that's why.
Yeah.
The storyline is close.
Oh,
then.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember.
I mean, you know, my daddy died when he was 29. That's the fact.
Mm-hmm.
And I was 3, and I, there's parts of that I don't watch.
I can understand.
Ralph, you remember the premiere, Everybody Cried Like a Baby?
Oh, I remember. Yeah, including yours truly.
Oh, yeah.
That
I remember
was the last time that did it for me.
Let me take a little break here. Nashville.
Give me two of those, Ralph.
Okay. Nash, they're Roger Miller's favorites, you know.
Yeah, I heard about
Nashville.
That.
They got to work then.
I heard about that.
Nashville Now is brought to you tonight by Goodies. The Extra Strength formula is the best-selling headache powder in the Southeast, and that same formula is now available in tablet form. Goodies for fast pain relief. I'm going to give you a couple right now. Eh? We'll be right back. The young lady you're about to meet has just accomplished something that, old hat for you now, but she has just succeeded in having her first top 10 record, and that was Dear Me. And she is a dear favorite of ours. Would you please welcome Miss Lori Morgan?
Just like I need you. Hold me, love me. beautiful.
I always worry about what we're going to do with Lori's knees.
That's all right. Let them stay there.
How you doing?
All right.
Did you bring your jacket?
My jacket is right there.
You want to acknowledge it?
Where sure, it? I'll acknowledge it.
This came to my office. A lady made this for Lori.
Yes, her name is Ginger. And she just...
I'll hold it.
Okay. She just decided that she wanted to do something nice for me. And she had this jacket, and she put my name on it and put all these little studs and stuff on it. And I just thought it was nice, and it came to Ralph's office, and we thought we would acknowledge it. I think it's a nice jacket.
I just noticed something on the back. I guess she thinks you are the Yellow Rose of Texas, because...
It does say... I think she's from Texas.
And there, that appears to be a rose on the back.
Yes.
That's nice.
Very nice. I appreciate that very much.
How have you been?
I've been great, Ralph.
Congratulations on your top 10 record.
Thank you. I appreciate that. I've waited a long time for that.
Are you doing the follow-up tonight?
We are going to do my brand-new single that was just released yesterday, called Out of Your Shoes. We're going to be doing that tonight.
Have you been on the road with Kenny Rogers?
I certainly have, and it's been a blast. We worked with Kenny 4 days in Valley Forge, Pennsylvania this past week, and opened for him. And he is absolutely one of the nicest people I've ever worked with. He really is. And we did 2 duets on his show together. We did Every Time Two Fools Collide. Mm-hmm. And I feel sorry for anyone who isn't me tonight. And that was, he really made me feel comfortable and at ease.
That make your heart go bumpity bumpity.
I must admit, I had goosebumps. I really did.
That's terrific. Well, is there a story about a walkie-talkie?
Yes, there is, actually. After I had met Kenny a couple days later, he's got a great sense of humor, in which I feel that I have a pretty good sense of humor myself. And I was sitting on the bus, and where my bus was sitting, I could look out and see the marquee, and his name was in real big, bold letters, Kenny Rogers, you know, and little tiny Lori Morgan right underneath it. So I was sitting there looking at it. And I told one of my guys, I said, would you mind taking this walkie-talkie into Kenny's dressing room? And so they took it in. He didn't know anything that was going on. And he said, hello. And I said, Kenny? He said, yeah. I said, it's your old buddy Lori out here on the bus. And he said, yeah. And I said, I was just sitting here looking at the marquee. And something is really wrong with this. And he said, what is it? And I said, well, your name is actually taking away from mine a little bit. And he said, don't worry about it, I'll fix it. So he never did, but we were going to do it anyway, but we didn't.
You tell me you have a sense of humor.
I have a little bit, yeah.
You ought to, being George Morgan's daughter.
That's right.
Oh, absolutely.
That's right.
Yeah.
But I had to talk to Lori about something important recently, and I tracked her down and found that she was on the road, and I called this motel Saturday morning. It's like 9 o'clock. I don't realize, of course, that they've been traveling all night, and she's not even off the bus yet. And so they went and got her. I said, I've got to talk to Lori.
And I was as hoarse as I could be. Yeah. I was talking like this.
Anyway, she came on the phone. She said, this had better be important.
That sounds like both seasons.
Yeah.
We'll take a break. We'll be right back.
And it wasn't.
Yeah, it wasn't.
There's more to go with Hank Williams Jr.
Now, I spoke to Senator Kilgore one day, called you down in Paris.
That's right.
And that was the first time you told me about Hank's new Monday Night Football project.
Right.
So I want one of you to tell me about how Hank is now going to be involved in Monday Night Football.
Hank is the spokesman, and as Frank Gifford says, he is the fourth man in the booth.
Hank, what does he mean by that?
They asked Hank to take his song, All My Rowdy Friends Are Coming Over Tonight, and change it to All My Rowdy Friends Are Coming Over Monday Night.
It's their 20th anniversary. Monday Night Football has been on ABC television for 20 years. Not many TV shows have been around 20 years. And I just couldn't believe it when Merle called me. He said, they want you. We've got to go to Los Angeles, and then we've got to go to Nashville. We're going to do the video and audio. They want all my rowdy friends are coming over tonight. And it was on last Monday night,
last
the Monday night before that, and we'll be on all year long.
I assume you are also a fan of Monday Night Football.
Oh, yeah, you bet I am. Yeah,
have
I really like it.
Have you wagered a few quarters on
it? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I love it. It makes it interesting.
Did you like Howard Cosell?
Well,
in his day, he was all right.
You know, now, you're not really watching those guys. You're watching what's going on the
okay,
field.
Okay, I understand. Yeah. But usually everybody has an opinion about Howard Cosell. I thought I would just ask.
Well, that was, you know, a long time ago. I liked Kenny Stabler and those kind of guys with the Raiders when I was watching that. And Dan Dierdorf, Al Michaels, and Frank Gifford, they were wonderful to work with.
Who is your favorite pro team? Which is your favorite
pro
team?
The one that wins by the margin.
I see. All right. Now, is this the first thing you see Monday night when the football game comes on?
Well,
the first minute.
One night they do that, then the next time they use halftime. See, they've got a lot of different, we worked on this for about 6 weeks. They've got a lot of different views.
But this will start Monday night football.
All right. Well, what we're going to do then, we're going to take a look now at Bo Cephas and his rowdy friends.
It was made right here in Nashville, by the way.
Okay, and it's, pretend it's Monday night and you're watching ABC.
Hey, the pizza's here, guys.
Hey, pizza.
Is that game on yet?
Pepperoni sausage.
Monday night time. Football, that is. When those red hot teams play under the lights, those X's and O's just seem to ignite. Now I know some guys that are ready to blitz, and some big old dudes will be taking their licks. I bet they're cheering like we are all over the land, jumping up and down like the fans in the stands. Nobody does a football like an ABC. Why, it's the only game for people like me. Friends are here for Monday night. Yes, everybody's a fan. Hey, this is the biggest party, man. We got Frank and Al and Dan. They really got it started. Week after week, it's the time that is right. All my rowdy friends are here on Monday night.
I love that little old lady on the front row.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. This is the first time, incidentally, that any network has ever sponsored a country music star for NFL football.
I think it's terrific. Where'd you shoot? Where would the...
Wonderful.
Where were the sequences with the girls shot?
What, Ralph?
The girls.
Where were they?
Yeah, was that shot here at Vanderbilt?
They were on the bus with me, naturally.
No. I mean, when they were out on the field dancing.
I don't know where they were. You know, just different cities and different teams. And it's just unbelievable to me to be sitting here watching that, because I'm a big football fan. And, you know, the Terry Bradshaws and the Dan Hamptons, that they play guitar and sing. And Walter Payton, they've been in the videos. But those guys make a living,
Did they investigate first to see if Hank was a fan before they came up with
Absolutely. The idea? Absolutely. Yes, I got a call right out of the blue, and our agent Curry Walls on the West Coast says, excuse me, Merle, does Hank like professional football? I said, are you kidding?
Is a school
bus
yellow?
Well, the president
if I've got three TVs,
Sports.
I'll get three of them going at once if I can. I try to keep up with all of them.
Okay. The president of ABC Sports is a big Hank Williams Jr. fan. I said, hello, hello.
I'd like to introduce to this gathering the senior vice president of sales and promotion for Warner Brothers Records, Nick Hunter. And Nick, I just want to say hi to you.
Hello, Ralph.
We don't have all the players here yet. And Merle.
It's really here.
Yeah, no.
Merle, we have for Nick's purposes, we have one more player, and I wish you would bring him on.
Yes. Well, ladies and gentlemen, here's the man that you personally can thank for keeping a legend alive. Ladies and gentlemen, from Bernie, Texas, Big Bill Lister. A tear in my beer. Hey, Big Bill.
Hey, Bill. All right.
Sit down, Bill.
Now, I believe later in this program we are going to talk about that story, and we're going to play the video of Tear in My Beer. But that's not the reason that Nick is here at the moment. Nick, I've got a sack full of...
Of goodies, yes.
Of goodies, all right.
Well, you know, in this day and age of country music, a album sell a lot, like this man sells. I don't know how many platinum gold we've had, but a whole bunch. But this day and age, single records do not sell nearly what they used to. In fact, the criteria for a gold record used to be 1 million. It is now down to 500,000. Well, the crack research department at Warner Brothers Records did some research, and we've come up with a figure. Hank's Tear in My Beer that Mr. Lister found in his attic, I believe, has sold in excess of 300,000 records, which is the largest selling record that our research shows in over 5 years.
All right.
So to commemorate this occasion, Ralph, can I have, which one is this one?
This is Hank's.
This is Hank's? Well, we'll start off. We're almost to gold. There's a half a gold record.
I never
you,
saw
sir.
A half a gold record before.
I haven't seen one.
And this is Merle's.
Good.
Yeah,
God.
And the reason we're giving one to Merle is he called and said, you can't be on TV unless I get one, too.
Oh, that's right.
So there's one for Merle.
Business is business.
And this is for Bill.
And, folks, this is a very special one because, again, without this gentleman sitting right next to me, Big Bill Lister, this thing would have never come to light, and history would have gone unserved because Acuff Rose would have always wondered, what's that song doing in their songbook? They never heard. Right. Bill, this is for you, sir.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bill. Let me show them.
I've never seen a half a gold record award,
but that's one tonight.
Merle used to tell me about a lot of half gold records a few years ago.
By the way, if it goes gold, you come back and
give
them?
Oh, we got the other half.
Of
we're
course.
Working the other half right now.
Okay. We're going to take a little break, and we'll be right back in a moment. Well, he is certainly no stranger to hit records, and he's got another one. It's, I believe, number 15, moving up this week, called Finders or Keepers. Here again is Bo Cephas, Hank Jr.
In the middle of a field.
haystack would be easy to do compared to me finding somebody else like you. I tell you, chasing the perfect woman is just about like rolling the dice. She's as pretty as a natural 11, and I'm putting my heart on the line. Finders are keepers, and I'm keeping you as long as I can. Finders, finders are keepers.
People.
Why don't you read the card and I'll hold up the product.
Nashville Now is brought to you tonight by the new Coleman Electronic Ignition Lantern. You turn it on by merely turning a knob. No matches required. Coleman, the best idea in lighting since the Dark Ages.
This song earlier, Lori Morgan's first top 10 hit. Here's Lori to sing Dear Me.
Would he run that road, dear?
Nashville Now will continue live after this short break. You're watching TNN. Pass the word.
Owner.
All right, what we're going to do, we're just going to move Lori down about 10 or 15 feet to what we call downstage center here at Nashville Now. And we're going to debut on Nashville Now tonight the song that will follow Dear Me and hopefully right back into the top 10. It's called Out of Your Shoes. Here again is Lori Morgan. Lori, thank you. That's very pretty. That's the newest record by Lori Morgan. Now we're going to change the subject and go back to A Tear in My Beer, which I think is one of the recording events of the year. Fortunately for us, the video of Tear in My Beer debuted on Nashville Now. I'd like to go to Big Bill Lister. Well, let me go to you. Merle, I want you to introduce Big Bill Lister properly, and let's background him. And then, Big Bill, I want you to tell us about...
No, I'm going to introduce him. Merle introduces everybody.
Okay, all right.
This gentleman here played guitar for Daddy. And believe it or not, he is one of the finest firearms engravers around. To think that a guy 6'7" with the big old gangly hands could do that, And we've known each other not only in the musical field, but hunting wild hogs and all kind of stuff down in Texas. And for that to happen, we didn't go over there that day with that in mind. We were talking about gun grips and stuff, and he said, here, take this record with you, by the way. Anyway, that's where it all started. Ladies and gentlemen, from Bernie, Texas, Daddy's old guitar player, Big Bill Lister.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Now, Big Bill, how did you happen to run across A Tear in My Beer?
Well, Ralph, long story, as they say, this started back in 1951. I needed the beer tune. I was recording for Capitol Records at that time, and I was short a tune. We were in off the road. I'd been front man for Hank Williams on the road out of the Grand Ole Opry. And we were in late October 1951. Hank had a session one night for MGM. I had a session the next night for Capitol. And I told Hank the night, I was down with the Bits and the boys at the studio that night, the old Castle Studios here in town. And I told Hank, I'm really hurting, buddy. I need a song, a beer drinking song. And he said, don't worry about it. I'll fix you up with one that'll cock their pistol. And I assume I left early that night, and I assume that after they got through with the session, Hank cut this demo. You remember in 1951, we didn't have the convenience of tapes and cassettes and being easy to do it. But he recorded that apparently right there in Castle Studio.
Got a demo.
It's just him and his guitar.
All right, now, did you record this for Capitol?
Yes. The next morning after Hank told me he'd get a tune, he brought me that demo. I learned it that morning, went in the studio that night and recorded it for Capitol. Hank and I felt like we had a real winner then. We didn't know it was going to take 38 years and Bo Cephas show it.
All right. Now, let me ask you this. So you went down to see him, and he brought out the old demo.
Yes. Right.
Now, I have another demo from the same stack.
Same box, right?
And it's an old, what we call an acetate. It's an aluminum base, and it has an acetate covering, and the grooving is in the acetate. Excuse me. You live in Texas. It's hot in Texas. And everybody has asked me, how in the world, all those summers, did that acetate survive in the attic?
I don't know. I'll tell you what, in July and August, you might near bake Indian bread in my attic down there. And out of about 12 or 15 records that was in that box, Tear in My Beer, and about two more records came out perfect. The rest of those records look just like that one you just showed.
Right.
It is,
when
to
you
me,
heard it,
it's meant to be.
When you heard it, Hank, did you immediately get the idea to record with your father?
Well, not immediately, because, Merle listened to it, I listened to it, you know, and you just don't imagine a new song by Daddy that's been around for almost 40 years. And it takes a while to hit you. You know, we couldn't believe it. And, you know, we called different people and said, have you ever heard that song? No. Have you ever heard it? No. Have you ever heard of it? No. So what we had was an original song of Daddy's, an original Hank Williams song that had never been recorded except by Bill and his, we
didn't know about that either until Merle and Bill told me.
So then I was ready. I said, this is something I've always wanted to do. Mm-hmm. We did all that other when they threw my voice on when I was 17, 18 years old with Daddy. I said, now I want to do one on an equal basis with him as if we were doing a brand new duet. And to me, that's the biggest thrill that I'll ever have doing that.
All right, well, we're going to play the video for you. I think this video, by the way, has been nominated for Video of the Year, and I think it'll win. It's a classic as Hank Jr. sings with Hank Sr.
There's a tear. Shed a million tears. You are on my lonely mind.
These tears will leave my eyes. There's a tear in my beard, 'cause I'm crying for you, dear. You are on my lonely mind.
Last night I walked the floor, and the night before, you were on my lonely mind. It seems my life is through, and I'm so doggone blue.
Okay, now, what actually Hank Williams was singing was Hey Good Looking on the Kate Smith Show.
Right.
How did you do it? How did you make it appear that he was singing Tear in My Beer? Also, how did you get the effect of you walking among the band members?
Don't ask me, Ralph. I'm not a video technician. I'm an audio man, you know. There was a lot of computer work, and it was a very expensive video to make, according to Warner Brothers. And of course, when you're spending the money, their money, you don't care. So,
wait a minute, we paid half.
Oh yeah, well,
but there had to be some technique to make his lips appear to be singing those words.
Yeah, well,
they auditioned lips.
They auditioned lips.
They did.
Excuse me.
They auditioned lips.
To fit him.
Hank had real thin lips. You know, that top lip was real thin. And they auditioned lips.
Ethan Russell, the director, that's how they did it.
Mm-hmm.
There was a lot of work
so
went into that.
So actually, you saw Hank's face with somebody else's lips.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Singing,
interesting. There's eight.
But I don't think about any of that. I don't care about that. I'm not going to ruin the magic of that. I see Daddy singing his song with me on that video, and that's all I see.
All right. All right.
Hey.
Well, that's what I see.
That's
they do too. That's what they want.
Right. That is the appearance you give as we watch your reaction in the video.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. There was some magic moments there when we made that video.
But
this young actor Dennis Stone portrayed.
But I have to tell you, I think it's the cleverest piece of video I have seen.
Very well, good. Coming from you, that's quite a statement, because you've seen a lot.
All right, we're going to take a little break here. My friends, we'll be right back.
You in part by Hunt's Ketchup. When it comes to thickness and taste, you can't beat Hunt's Ketchup.
Hey, let's go back to the famous Bama Band. Here we go.
Hey! I thought I was the sophisticated kind. I've looked at life like modern lovers do. This game I said from bed to bed and never hurts these days. But now the joke's on me since I lost you. And I play Hank Jr. on the jukebox. Order of old whiskey at the bar. Through my tears I lie another lucky. I've got a real old-fashioned broken around and in and out of lovers' arms before. Thought it was just for fun this day and time. Love, I said, it's all in your head. You don't feel it anymore. But losing change my mind. And I play Hank Jr. on the jukebox. An order of old whiskey at the bar. Another lucky. I've got a real old-fashioned broken heart. Yes, I play Hank Jr. on the jukebox. I've got a real old-fashioned.
That is the famous Bama Band. And Nashville Now is brought to you tonight by the new Coleman Electronic Ignition Lantern. You turn it on merely by turning a knob. No matches are required. Coleman, the best idea in lighting since the Dark Ages.
Presenting the newest idea in lighting and the oldest idea. The new Coleman Electronic Ignition Lantern and the torch. Both are easy to carry and easy to adjust. But the Coleman Lantern...
Now then, before this last song, Hank has a very special dedication. Hank, take it away.
Well, a lot of people have seen my son, Shelton, who's taller than I am in the video Young Country and in magazines. These are my daughters, Hillary and Holly. Hillary on the left and Holly on the right, and they are... probably also born to boogie.
Yeah, my mama met my daddy down in Alabama. They tied the knot, so here I am. Born on the bayou on the Texas line. Loving Louisiana and raised on jambalaya. But now before I could walk, I had a guitar in my hand. I had my own band. Went on the road when I was 8 years old. Turned 15, I could steal any show. Money to burn, girls are pretty. Didn't take me long to learn I was born to boogie. When I was 18, I went to Hollywood, I met Elvis and Marilyn and Johnny B. Good. Got my guitar painted, California sun, a red Cadillac having too much fun. Oh, we're playing them halls and jamming them, moved it on over to MGM. This is the bud we told you about. He lit a cigar and he stuck his hand out. Give you 50,000, make a movie star too. I told him my mama didn't raise no fool. I take your money, I make a movie. I can tell you right now, I was born to boogie.
Music videos and up-to-date country information as Shelly Mangrum takes you through concert schedules, names in the news, and exciting feature stories. Yep. On the Nashville Network.